Hello everyone, welcome to our Let's Play series of Stalker, Call of Pripyat Misery. This is Gurnal RPG as usual, and I'm very happy that you chose to join me today. I think I need to sleep a little bit, but we'll see about that, because look at my stamina, it's not the top of condition, but I wanted to show you what we got from last episode. First off, we got a few of these grenades, which is always nice, so that I can use them with my Storm. OTS-14. We also got this Vintores? What's it called? A Val, I suppose. VSS silencer. It's got a permanent silencer. It's basically a sniper rifle, I think. Yeah, it's Vintores. It's called the Vintores sniper rifle. But it's really good as just an assault rifle. I really enjoyed it. I played it on, I think, I only play with it in the first game, or did I play with it as well in the second game here on the channel? I don't know, but it's gonna be good. We can use it, which is great. We also got this unidentified weapon, which is actually the thing that we're gonna need to worry about at the beginning of this episode. We also got a Galil over there. It's not in very good condition. We're not really gonna use it, but it's we're not gonna use it at all because we're not good with it. We also got an XM8 over here. XM8 over here, which is a very nice looking weapon right there. I think this thing is in the program was it says right there. I remember this being cancelled. The XM8 was a reconfigurable weapon system that underwent trials in the US to become the replacement for the M16 rifle and the M4 carbine. It includes an integrated optical sight and IR laser aiming module, but it was cancelled. I remember reading about this one the first time I saw it. Also, I got a Desert Eagle over here, a modern one. It's not in very bad condition. We might use that, but I will need to take into consideration the amount of what weapons I have back home as well. But anyway, well, that's pretty good over there. We have taken care of our repairs, and we need to go and talk to the guy that gave us the order. We also need to get the order to go get the weapon. We also need to ask about this place because there's a few things that we need to talk about. That as well. What I'm gonna do is actually gonna be a little bit weird. Let's see. There he is. What I'm gonna do... Let's see. I'm gonna drop the weapon. So I can ask him about other things. Oh, no. No! How's the operation going, he asks. Yeah, we took some losses. Well, every one of us, except for me. Monolith fighters led us into a trap by sacrificing their own people. They don't seem to care for individual lives. Some of them even turned to suicide bombing. I didn't see that happening, but sure. Nah, bastards. They couldn't have known about our plan. So we've lost some men. What about the aim of the operation? Yeah, I got the weapon. It was damaged during the fighting. Oh, so we can't determine whether it was used to shoot down the helicopters. Listen, Major. You've got connections among the zoners. It's possible that they have come across this weapon before. They should have technicians among them. Will you try talking to them? Yeah? Good. Oh, by the way, another stalker made it here from Jupiter. Have a chat with him first, if you feel like it. Okay, so the...
I've received a message from the recon unit.
So?
Dude, what the hell is that? Wait! We're all dead! Help! Someone help me! Get that thing away from me! No!
Recon unit! Come in. What is going on out there? We need to find the recon unit. Major, find out what happened. What the hell? You be careful out there, okay? And Major, keep me posted.
Yeah. Okay. So we have a recon unit being sent down. Whatever that was. Let's have a chat with him, because I need information. We need to talk about a lot of things. About Operation Fairway. Did something unusual... That's the operation that brought the helicopters in here. That's why we're here. That's the main quest. Did something unusual happen while the helicopters were in the air? Until the choppers started crashing, he says. We stuck the operation plan. Took off 90 seconds before the emission, activated our protection systems, and put the birds on autopilot. We were following the shortest safe route, calculated using the anomaly map. The fact that we had zero visibility shouldn't have affected the mission because the corridor was wide enough. According to the plan, we should have reached the power plant in 12 and a half minutes. After 9 minutes, we lost comms with Stingray 4, and then the others started dropping like flies. Okay, I have a few more questions then. What happened to the helicopters? Nah, not much. Oh, what happened to the... Not much happened? Oh, yeah, I know what he means. Stingray 2 is a complete mystery. I don't know where it crashed or what happened to the man on board. You should know more about Stingray 4 than I do. Lieutenant Sokolov, the one that came here with you, is the only survivor of that, from that chopper. The information about the other choppers comes from men who made it. So, don't expect an accurate picture. We have other things to worry about. Yeah, what about number 1? I was on it. As soon as comms with Stingray 4 went down, I informed the others of the designated evacuation point in Pripyat. I thought we could walk to the power plant. Almost immediately after that, chopper took a hit, and I could smell something burning. The engine caught fire. The pilots managed to get us to the helipads near Jupiter plant, but they were both killed on impact. Then we lost Sergeant Shliachin. When it turned out that the approach to the helipads was full of mines. We lost another man, senior lieutenant in Pripyat, while fighting monolith soldiers for this building. For this building, yeah. And how did you get here? Well, we met a stalker not far from the minefield. I think he must have heard the mines exploding. A strange guy. Called himself Guide. He didn't ask any questions and just offered to lead us to Pripyat. That suited our plan, so I agreed. We kept him out of our sights, just in case, but everything went smoothly. He didn't say a word until we reached the city. And when we did, he just disappeared without a warning. I ordered my men to leave him be. Okay. So what about number 3? Captain Tarasov says that both engines failed. They had to land on the hill around position B2. They were lucky in that they had a soft landing, but the technician didn't have time to identify the cause of the malfunction because they were attacked by snorks and lost 3 men. The others decided not to stick around. Then they contacted Stingray 5 and went to meet them. Yeah, I think this is the first helicopter that we saw. They got into a fight with a well-armed enemy squad on the way, but managed to get out of there without taking losses. Okay. How did they get to Pripyat? The crews of Stingrays 5 and 3 managed to link up not far from the crash locations near some sort of barge. It was reported to me that the man who lived there was crazy as a loon. When my men tried to detain him, he tried to detain them. I mean, the poor bastard was outnumbered 11 to 1. Anyway, chancing upon this stalker turned out to be a fortunate development, as the parties managed to come to an agreement, and he led the whole squad to Pripyat almost unharmed. The only casualty was Lieutenant Stetsenko, who lost a couple of toes in a gravitational anomaly on his way here. Oh, that wasn't a casualty then. What about Stingray 5? Oh, the electronics malfunctioned and Stingray 5 dropped straight into a swamp. 5 men survived the crash. They were contacted by Stingray 3 as they were getting their equipment out of the chopper. The squad commander, Major Neborski, died on the way to the meeting point. Poor bastard was sucked dry by a bloodsucker near the scanning station. The others made it without any problems. They lost another man, Senior Sergeant Batyai, one of the snipers, when they reached Pripyat. And got into a fight with monolith forces. How did they get here? The crews of... Oh, no, goes back to that. Okay, good stuff. Tell me about the monolith. Oh, they're fanatics, pure and simple. I don't know what's spurring them on, but they're constantly looking for a fight. They don't retreat even if they are outnumbered and outgunned. And that's pretty rare for this place. It looks like they're getting regular reinforcements from the power plant. Keep in mind that if outgunned or outnumbered, they're likely to activate explosives, killing themselves and everyone around them. We've lost really good men because of those lunatics. Yeah, I didn't see that. Have you tried interrogating one of them? Ah, it's useless. First of all, they fight to the death. Then our boys managed to get one alive when he was stunned by a grenade, but it didn't help much. We took our eyes off him for a second, and he banged his head against the wall so hard that his skull cracked open like an egg. Mm-hmm. So, what are you doing now? I don't believe it's possible to go ahead with Operation Fairway. Your presence here confirms it. My plan is to hold the base until the choppers show up. I have several possible evacuation places, or dates. Yeah, but there won't be any choppers until we know what caused the Stingrays to crash. So that's how it is. Well, we can't make it out of here on foot. God knows how many miles of this shit. And then the zone is full of zoners who aren't exactly our best buddies. This means our only choice is to conduct our own investigation. And I'll buy the farm in the process. Major, we're working towards the same goal here. Yep, we are. We very much are. So that's that. I'll see you later, man. Now, we have 2 missions. One of which is to find... is to go with an unidentified weapon. Find information. Who am I going to talk to about this thing? And the other one... Well, it's that one. Missing squad. Oh, yeah, we've been there before. not necessarily gonna go well. I still wanna go out there, though. I think I need sleep. But we're gonna take care of other things before that happens. I think I can also repair that. Even though it's unidentified, I'm pretty sure it's repairable. Let me see. It's also very heavy. Hey, sir. Let me see. Can you repair this? He can. Oh, it's not clear how the weapon works. No, we can't. I can click on yes, but yeah. Doesn't matter. We're going outside and putting that in there and everything else. Actually, I don't need to bring this one. And everything else is okay. We're gonna go artifact hunting. I think I repaired all my stuff. I mean, I should have. That's what I said at the beginning of the episode, I think. If I didn't, that's what I should have said. Because that's what I was doing off camera. Apart from preparing to record another episode. So, from here, where can we go? We have this building, and we have that building. A few things to see. Hopefully nothing terrible coming our way. Let me see if I can climb. Probably not. No, cannot climb. Maybe over there? Probably not. Oh, almost. I don't think they're configured as climbable, as ladders. Of course we're gonna be attacked. This is a possible thing. Maybe. Keeping an eye on here. Over there, there's the hospital. I guess we should go there, shouldn't we? Just find out what happened to them. And get myself killed. Yeah, this place looks exactly like the other one. Well, I say exactly. It looks very similar to the other one. But it's not. The other place that we were fighting before. Still has the same passages back there. And we have been here before. We've definitely been here before. Yeah, I'm gonna need to use non-piercing ammo here for a little while. But as long as we are not ambushed, we should be able to control the environment. So I'm not really too afraid of having to shoot them repeatedly in the head to get through their helmets. Huh. Oh, you saw that, didn't you? It wasn't the... That was a dog. Yeah, definitely. Well, let's hunt some dogs then. Also, there's a... This road is not in good condition. There they are. That's the enemies. Or the enemies. That's the squad. I mean, not the enemies. The enemies are here. Did you see them? Did you see the squad? Of course, the big danger here will always be... Let's go with this. The big danger here will always be psychic enemies and stuff like that. Okay, I definitely triggered the dogs. They're pretty upset. Problem is they're a pack enemy, which means their path is really weird. And I might get killed. I mean, it's possible. See how they're all weird? Well, okay, one of them's dead. That's a kill. They don't need two shots, I don't think. Oh. Okay. Nope, I'm dead. Maybe not. Come on. They're nasty, and the frame rate doesn't help. You're dead. Okay. I think I shot him. Hey. And the other guy's gonna run away. Yeah, these guys are we need to deal with them because there they are. We need to deal with them because if we don't, then we can't really investigate that too well. And we need to. Okay, where are we? Nothing terrible is showing up. There's a door. Seems to be blocked. I'm pretty sure we can get to it, but it's just they don't open. This is either an anomaly. No, it's definitely anomalies. I like it. Anomalies in Pripyat. It's the best thing. No, they're on the ground. Definitely not above. Yeah, that's cool. Look at these things. Why would I do that? Is this a real thing? Why would you do that? Do you really need to access that thing up there that often? It's probably related to some sort of safety measure or a way to make it accessible, but not at the same but at the same time not too accessible. I don't understand why they just wouldn't put a door on it. I remember there being very nasty things in here. But fortunately, oh no, the game is definitely loading things. We have ourselves a stash with food. We're not under fire. I don't know how to get to that underground area. Doesn't matter, we'll get to it eventually. A lot of this stuff is just for eventually. I think I heard dogs this way. Can I? Excuse me. No? No? Okay, nothing. There's also no artifacts there, so it doesn't really matter. Also, another thing, the fact that we need to ask somebody about the mysterious weapon is gonna allow us to... probably gonna get us to do quests that we haven't done yet. So that's a nice thing. There's definitely a dog around here somewhere. And I don't know where I am. Okay, we're going to the bookstore. Well, let's go to the bookstore. Let's have a look. I mean, what is this? Oh, I know what the bookstore is. You can hear them. And you did. We're not gonna mess with them. They're monolith. Because I think we need to go first to the bodies of those guys, and then we can go to the bookstore. Because I think those might be responsible for the death of that squad over there. Of course, this is not a good approach, this one. The other one, the one that we took, is a good approach. I remember having a lot of trouble with this, especially because I don't have the nice armor here, so we're just kind of prepared for everything, really, at this point, but not really for bullets getting to us. Okay, so where are we going? I'm still a little bit ways down through here. Let me save the game and let's see what we can pull off. Hopefully good things. Look at that. There's things over there. You gonna get the quest update? Or do we need to open them? Yep. One of these guys. Well, there it is.
I found the unit. They're all dead. Looks like they were shot, but there's no trace of the enemy.
It's those damn fanatics.
It is.
We need to deal with them.
Yep.
The recon unit had information about the location of monolith forces. The notes indicate the bookstore.
Very well. I'll be sending two boys your way. They'll meet you near the target. Over and out.
Okay. So we have backup, which means we have more loot, because they're gonna die. Also, these guys have a lot of very nice stuff, which is really, really good, especially if you're playing with the latest version, which allows you to dismantle all these weapons and all that sort of stuff. That's really cool. Okay, we might need to drop a bit of it somewhere. There's a lot of things that we can see in here. It's getting late, isn't it? Yeah, it's 5 p.m. Can I go up? Don't think I No, I don't think I need to worry about this building. Or that other one, by the way. Okay, so our objective is to go there. That is a terrible idea. That is such a terrible idea. Why would you do that to me? Well, that's what I need to do. Oh, the reinforcements have arrived. So they will start shooting. Especially if there's dogs around there. By the way, did you see the... Did you see that cinematic? Of course you did. Well, maybe you didn't. Maybe you skipped. It's one of the... Oh. What? Sure. It's one of the reasons why I wanted to kill the dogs. Because getting that cinematic while being surrounded and attacked by dogs is not fun. Especially because it's just the cinematic. You can't cancel that. You can never cancel cinematics in this game. And we have been here before. We were here a couple of episodes ago. Now, of course... We're heading in the right direction. We're gonna need to... Oh, yeah. They're... I think... I thought they kind of waved us. Or waved at us. Caffeine is not enough. It's gonna be an interesting fight. It's always an interesting fight. It's always very interesting.
I signed up as soon as I found out you need help. I'll follow you to the bitter end, man.
Vanu! No, guys!
You know, I thought I'd be safer with you.
You idiots! Why did you... Oh no. They're already detected us. They're gonna get themselves killed. Maybe not. Maybe their AI is gonna be stupid. Oh? Okay, I killed one of them. This weapon is silenced, right? Yeah. And we have plenty of silencers for it as well. Which means I've probably got a little bit of ammo over here. That is acceptable, but no ammo. Got some scope, though. It's always nice. They have scopes. Even though it's moist field. Okay. So, this place... He's really nasty. See that guy over there? He doesn't see us. Where's the guy that I killed? Back there? No idea. Gonna need to switch ammo for this. Let's see what I can do here. There he is. Oh no. You're going in. Well, Vano is going in. They die. I don't want them to. I think I'm gonna die. Okay, get the bandage. Can you please not be idiots? No. They can't. Okay, get an army med kit here. Oh, these guys. And I was exposing myself completely. Because I have anti-bleeding things. I just don't know what they look like. Okay, I stopped bleeding. Yeah, I was exposing myself. That's why I was standing in the middle of the way, because that was... And you saw that. I mean, you saw him. He was going to be shot. He wasn't firing at the guy that was looking straight at him. Oh, man, these guys. Yeah, I think I did well. Are you alive? He's not. It's kind of in a sort of fetal position there. Okay, so that went really well. Really, really, really well. They're both here. There's still guys talking around here. I wish I could find a stash, though, because I want to stash a lot of this crap that I have with me. And yeah, getting through that window is also pretty decent. There's another... Oh, no. There's not another entrance through here. This guy was going to kill himself, I think. Or he was using a grenade, so he was going to kill us. But I think they come out through... Out there... Through that passage, and then attack us from the back, which is really nasty and not something we need. I'm gonna have this weapon. Switch the ammo. I don't understand why he does it. Why he did that? Did I reload or something? Okay, you can hear them talking. It's not a thing. We have night vision if we want to. I don't think I do. My shotgun is also silenced, by the way. I got lucky as all hell. And of course, that only happens because... Oh my god. That only happens because first-person shooters, real-time, and stuff like that. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't get in. Don't get in. Okay. We're safe. And we're out of time for the day as well. So for right now, I'm Colonel RPG. Don't you dare open that door. And this has been Stalker, Call of Pripyat, Misery. I really hope you've enjoyed it, and if you did, go ahead and leave a comment. Like the video if you want to see the next episode come out sooner rather than later. But above all, thank you so much for watching, and I hope I'll see you next episode. Bye-bye.